Hola, soy Memo, and this is Spanish with Memo, Español con Memo. So buenos días, buenas tardes, buenas noches. All right, so we went over the Spanish alphabet before. Today we're going to spell words using the alphabet. So it's pretty straightforward. We'll discuss some unique things about the words as necessary. All righty, so let's get right to it. So amarillo, okay, A-M-A-R-I-A-O, or A, depending on what in fact is yellow, right? Amarillo means yellow. Okay, buzón, B-U-Z-O-N, buzón, like a mailbox. You may also hear buzón as like a theta sound, mostly in Spain, Argentina, but you will hear that sound as well. But that is the letter Z or theta, no? Buzón. Caricatura, C-A-R-I-C-A-T-U-R-A, caricatura, like a cartoon. Destruir, D-E-S-T-R-U-I-R, destruir. That's a verb form, the IR verb, no? Destruir, okay? Elefante, E-L-E-F-A-N-T-E, means dog, no? No, it doesn't mean dog, it means elephant. Sí, muy bien. Gracias por prestar atención. Okay, feo or fea means ugly. F-E-O, F-E-A, depending on what in fact is ugly, right? Whether it's feminine or masculine. Geografía, la letra G, the letter G here. I have a soft G and a hard G. G-E-O-G-R-A-F-E-A, geografía. Although you have a soft G and a hard G, it's still the letter G, right? Muy bien, geografía. Huracán, H-U-R-A-C-A-N. And most of the time, the H is silent in Spanish, okay? So it's never huracán. It's always huracán. It's silent most of the time. So, but it's still the letter H-U-R-A-C-A-N, huracán. Ignacio, it's just a name, I-G-N-A-C-I-O. A nickname for Ignacio is Nacho. So if you know somebody named Ignacio, say, hola, Nacho, ¿cómo estás? Okay, muy bien. Joyería, J-O-Y-E-R-I-A, joyería, like a jewelry store. Joyería, J-O-Y, muy bien. Nombre means name. ¿Cuál es tu nombre? N-O-M-B-R-E, nombre. Ñame, it does not mean name, it means yam, ñame. N-A-M-E, ñame. We have ñu, N-U, the big burly animal, that big gnu, G-N-U, okay? Ñu. I put these because they're just fun to say, right? All right, quieto, Q-U-I-E-T-O. Quieto means silent or still, okay? Quieto. Romper, another verb here. It's an ER verb, no? R-O-M-P-E-R means to break, romper. Okay, querías, Q-U-E-R, the double R sound here, the longer trill, E-A-S. Now, could I have spelt it Q-U-E-R-R-E-I-S? Yes, of course. I could have spelled it with two short trill R's, no? Q-U-E-R-E-I-S. This is the conditional form of the verb querer, not in the second person singular, this means you would want. Okay, we'll go over that later. Uvas, U-B-A-S, means grapes. Sandia, S-A-N-D-I-A, sandia, watermelon. Here's charlar, charlar. That means to chat or to talk, another verb. So we have I-R, E-R, A-R verb, no? Charlar, che, or C-H, no? C-H-A-R-L-A-R, charlar, to chat or to talk. Viéramos, B-I-E-R-A-M-O-S, viéramos. That's the past subjunctive or the imperfect subjunctive of the verb ver, which means to see. This is advanced grammar, okay? We're not going over that yet, just learning how to spell it. Viéramos, alrighty? Whiskey, W-H, E-S-K-Y, or W, no? W or W, H-E-S-K-Y, whiskey, no? Fácil. Xilófono, that means guitar, X-E-L. No, it doesn't mean guitar, it means xylophone. Gracias por prestar atención. X-E-L-O-F-O-N-O, xilófono, no? Yerno, Y-E-R-N-O, yerno, means a son-in-law. Zapatero, Z-A, or theta, no? Z-A-P-A-T-E-R-O, zapatero. So there's a saying in Spanish that says, Zapatero a tus zapatos. The story is a zapatero was going to, real quick, so zapatero means shoemaker. It means shoemaker. So a zapatero had approached the sculptor and told the sculptor, hey, you're doing it all wrong. And the sculptor said, hey, zapatero, a tus zapatos. Shoemaker, to your shoes. In other words, mind your own business. Okay? Zapatero, a tus zapatos, mind your own business. Alrighty. However, your business is learning Spanish. I hope this is helpful. I hope you can use it. I hope you can spell words in your mind. And I think that's all for today. Muchas gracias por prestar atención. Adios.